a grade 5 chapter 3 plants and trees. Please check out the description for the subject references. Okay, let's move on to the video. Why plants and trees are important for humans? Oxygen. Plants and trees produce oxygen through photosynthesis. This is the process by which they use sunlight to convert carbon dioxide and water into oxygen and carbohydrates. Humans and other animals need oxygen to breathe. Food. Plants and trees provide us with food. We eat fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds from plants. We also eat meat from animals that eat plants. Shelter. Plants and trees provide us with shelter from the sun, rain, and wind. We build houses from wood and use leaves to make baskets and other objects. Climate regulation. Plants and trees help regulate the climate by absorbing carbon dioxide and releasing oxygen. They also help to cool the air by providing shade. Soil erosion prevention. Plants and trees help to prevent soil erosion by holding the soil in place with their roots. Recreation. We enjoy spending time in nature, and plants and trees provide us with beautiful places to relax and enjoy the outdoors. Education. Plants and trees can teach us about the natural world and the importance of conservation. Economic benefits. Plants and trees provide us with jobs in the forestry, agriculture, and tourism industry. Importance of trees. Plants are essential for life on earth. They produce oxygen. Plants provide food for animals and humans. They help maintain the water cycle. Importance of trees. Provides rain, purify our air, and combat climate change. Provide housing to millions of species that protect us from disease. Cool our streets and cities. Protect against floods and water pollution, and ease the mind during stressful times. Water them regularly. Give them enough sunlight. Remove weeds around them. Broccoli, cabbage, carrot, chili, beans, cauliflower, celery, cucumber, and eggplant, onion. Examples of fruits: apples, bananas, berries, grapes, oranges, pears, pineapples, strawberries, mango, and watermelon. In different places. Places where plants grow. They grow on mountains, deserts, water, in coastal areas, and in plains. Land. Plants grow on land in a variety of habitats, including forests, grasslands, deserts, and mountains. Water. Some plants can grow in water, such as algae and water lilies. Air. Some plants can grow in the air, such as aphids, which grow on the branches of trees. Artificial habitats. Plants can also be grown in artificial habitats, such as greenhouses and gardens. Parts of a plant. These are the main parts of a flowering plant: the flower, the bud, the fruit, the stem, the roots, and the leaves. In the fruits, we get the seeds, and in the stem, we get the sap. The roots anchor the plant in the soil and absorb water and nutrients. The stem supports the plant above the ground and transports water and nutrients from the roots to the leaves. Leaves. The leaves contain chlorophyll, which is used to convert sunlight into food for the plant. flowers. Flowers are the reproductive organs of the plants. They produce pollen and seeds. Fruits. Fruits are the ripened varieties of flowers. They can contain seeds that might be planted to grow new plants. Roots. Types of root systems. Taproots, adventurous, true adventurous, foliar, and fibrous. Anchoring. Roots anchor the plant in the soil and prevent it from being blown over by the wind. Absorption. Roots absorb water and nutrients from the soil. Water is used by the plant to transport nutrients and dissolve minerals throughout the plant. Storage. Roots store food that the plant has produced during photosynthesis. This food can be used by the plant during times of drought or when the plant is not producing enough food. Transport. Roots transport water and nutrients from the soil to the rest of the plant. This is done through a network of tubes called xylem and phloem. First, the seed is being planted. Then it will be germinating. Then the seed will finally sprout. Then the sprouted plant will start seeding. The seeding plant will become a fully grown plant. Then the plant will get flowers, and the plant with flowers will then get fruit, and then the fruit can be plucked out of the plant. Budding. A new plant grows from a bud on the parent plant. Fragmentation. The parent plant breaks into pieces and each piece grows into a new plant. Spore formation. The parent plant produces spores, which are tiny reproductive units that can grow into new plants. Vegetative propagation. A new plant is produced from a piece of the parent plant, such as the stem cutting or a root cutting. Seeds. Seeds travel by the wind, milkweed, dandelion, and maple, by animals, beggar or ticks, sandbur and blackberry, by water, lotus and cattail and coconut, by bursting, violet, jewelweed, and witch hazel, by humans, beans, wheat, and cherry. The dispersal of seeds refers to the process by which plants spread their seeds away from the parent plant to increase the chances of a successful germination and growth. It is an essential mechanism for plants to colonize new areas and ensure genetic diversity within populations. Methods of seed dispersal, which can be categorized into two main types, dispersal by agents and dispersal by itself. Dispersal by agents. Wind. Some plants have seeds that are lightweight and equipped with structures like wings, hairs, or parachutes, which enable them to be carried by wind over long distances. Examples include dandelions, maple trees, and cottonwood trees. Water. Seeds of certain plants are adapted to float on water, allowing them to be dispersed by rivers, streams, or ocean currents. Coconut palms and water lilies are an example of plants that disperse seeds through water. Animals. Many plants rely on animals to disperse their seeds. Dispersal by self. Self-propulsion. Some plants have mechanisms that enable the seed to expel forcefully from the parent plant. This can occur through the bursting of seed pods and seen in the case of peas or touch-me-not plants, Mimosa pudica, which disperse seeds through touch-sensitive movements. Gravity. Certain plants have heavy seeds that fall directly beneath the parent plant due to gravity. These seeds rely on the surrounding environment to provide favorable conditions for germination. Acorns from oak trees are a common example. Seed. Single seeds. Mango, plum, coconut, avocado, rambutan, and mangosteen. Multi-seed. Kiwi, papaya, watermelon, orange, guava, apple, jackfruit, and strawberry. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and share with your friends and family. We'll meet in another learning video. Bye-bye.